So under our umbrella heading, one dimensional steady state heat conduction without heat generation through homogeneous and isotropic material having constant thermal conductivity K with respect to temperature, let us discuss heat conduction through composite cylinder, which is also called as lagged pipe. Under this, we will also discussing combined modes of heat transfer. That is, we are going to consider heat transfer by conduction and convection as well. What is composite cylinder? The example of composite cylinder is a steam pipe carrying a high pressure steam from boiler to turbine is provided with two or three layers of materials, insulating materials of different thermal conductivity, and finally a material like plaster is provided over this to make it stronger. The purpose of this is to prevent heat loss from steam to the surrounding. So such pipe is called as composite pipe. Sometimes it is also referred as lagged pipe. And the process of providing different layers of materials over a plane or base cylinder is called as lagging. So one such composite cylinder or lagged pipe is shown in figure. The cylinder shown by the black color is base cylinder or plane cylinder having its thermal conductivity K1. It is provided with two layers of insulating material 1 and 2 having thermal conductivities K2 and K3 respectively. Let's say the length of the cylinder is L. This cylinder is carrying hot fluid like steam or water inside, having its temperature T infinity I and convective heat transfer coefficient H infinity I. This entire arrangement is exposed to the cold fluid outside like air having its temperature T infinity O and convective heat transfer coefficient H infinity O. By virtue of this temperature difference between hot and cold fluid, heat transfer will take place from inside of the cylinder to the outside. And here we are assuming heat conduction only in one direction, and that is also radial direction. So I am not considering any heat transfer either in tangential direction or in axial direction. By virtue of this heat conduction from inside of the cylinder to the outside of the cylinder, temperatures of the different material will change, and locus of such temperatures is called as temperature profile. And in case of cylinder, as we know, the variation of this temperature profile is logarithmic in nature, and it will be drawn by a curved line. Let us say radius inside radius of the cylinder is R1. The radius of the cylinder the outer radius of the cylinder is R2. The radius after providing insulation 1 is R3. And finally, radius of the cylinder after providing insulating material 2 is R4. And T1, T2, T3 and T4 are the temperatures at inner surface of the cylinder, at cylinder and insulating material 1 interface, insulating material 1 and insulating material 2 interface, and at the outer surface of the cylinder respectively. So here, since different materials are in contact, like cylinder material, insulating material 1 and insulating material 2, so it is forming basically a composite structure. And we know whenever there is a composite structure, thermal contact resistance may come into picture or may not come into picture. So for this analysis initially, I am not assuming any thermal contact resistance and its effect initially. Later on, we can discuss it. So the entire discussion will be excluding the effect of thermal contact resistance. So here, as you can see, there is a fluid surface in contact with the inner surface of the cylinder, and at the outer side, cold fluid surface is in contact with the outer surface of the cylinder. So here, the combined mode of heat transfer will come into picture, because heat transfer from fluid to the surface takes place by convection. And inside the solid material, heat transfer takes place by conduction. So let us draw the equivalent electrical circuit for this composite cylinder carrying hot and cold fluid inside. So the flow quantity will be heat transfer. The first potential difference will be temperature difference between hot fluid and inner surface of the cylinder, and it will offer one resistance. Let me represent this resistance by RT infinity I. The second potential difference will be between inner surface of the cylinder and interface temperature of cylinder and insulating material 1. And let's say it will offer thermal resistance RT1. The third potential difference in the form of temperature difference between insulating material 1 and insulating material 2, and let's say the thermal resistance is RT2. The next potential difference will be temperature difference between T3 and T4, and this will offer again thermal resistance, RT3. And finally, the temperature difference between outer surface of the cylinder and cold fluid, and this cold fluid will offer thermal resistance RT infinity O. And finally, heat will come out from the cylinder. So as you can see here, 5 thermal resistances are coming into picture. Out of these 5 thermal resistances, 2 will be convective thermal resistances, that is RT infinity I and RT infinity O, and these three thermal resistances will be by conduction or conductive thermal resistances, because RT1 is the thermal resistance offered by the cylinder, RT2 is the thermal resistance offered by insulating material 1, and RT3 is the thermal resistance offered by the insulating material 3. So that way total 5 resistances will come into picture. And mind well, we are not considering any effect due to thermal contact resistance. Now let us analyze this. So since we have assumed steady state and one dimensional steady state heat conduction, so under steady state and one dimensional heat condition, the rate of heat transfer through the two fluid layers and three solid material layers will be same. That is, rate of heat transfer is equal to rate of heat transfer from inside of the fluid to the inner surface layer of cylinder by convection, then from inner surface to the outer surface of the material cylinder Q1 to 2, then from interface 2 to interface 3, and finally from interface 3 to interface 4, and last one from outer surface of the cylinder to the cold fluid. Out of this 5 rate of heat transfer, this will be by convection, this 3 rate of heat transfer will be by conduction because through solid material, and final rate of heat transfer, that is Q4A, will again be by convection because it is between solid surface and fluid. Now let us write down the equations of rate of heat transfer. So now we are conversant with writing this. So how can I write rate of heat transfer or equation of heat transfer rate in convection? By Newton's law of cooling. So it will be H infinity I into AI into temperature difference T infinity I minus T1. Then Q12 is the rate of heat transfer through cylindrical wall. That also we have seen, 2 pi K1 is the thermal conductivity of the insulating material, L T1 minus T2 over log of R2 over R1. Q23 will be rate of heat transfer from cylinder to the insulating material 1. Again, it is a cylindrical wall, 2 pi K2 L T2 minus T3 over log of R3 over R2. Then rate of heat conduction through insulating material 2 having thermal conductivity K3. So rate of heat equation will be 2 pi K3 L T3 minus T4. Let us write it clearly so that you don't get confused. T3 minus T4 over log of R4 over R3, and finally from surface to the cone fluid, H infinity O into outer area of the cylinder into temperature difference. Which is T4 minus T infinity O. So let me give the equation number to each of this equation. It is equation number 1, 2, 3, 4. And last one is 5. Now let us arrange all these equations into our standard form of potential difference and thermal resistances. So Q is equal to T infinity I minus T1 over 1 over H infinity I into AI. Then second equation can be written as T1 minus T2 over log of R2 by R1 over 2 pi K1 L. Then third equation can be written as T2 minus T3 over log of R3 over R2 over 2 pi K2L. Fourth equation can be written as T3 minus T4 over log of R4 over R3 over 2 pi K3L. And finally, the fifth equation can be written as T4 minus T infinity O over 1 over H infinity O into AO. We have arranged all these equations of rate of heat transfer through different fluids and solid materials. Now, further, I can write them as Q is equal to T infinity I minus T1 over RT infinity I is equal to T1 minus T2 over RT1 is equal to T2 minus T3 over RT2 is equal to T3 minus T4 over RT3, and finally T4 minus T infinity O. Let us put bracket. Over RT infinity O. Now, in all these equations, if I compare this equation and this equation from here, now I can have important relations where RT infinity I is convective thermal resistance. Of hot fluid to the path of the heat conduction Q, and it can be given as 1 over H infinity I into AI. And what will be unit? Unit will be Kelvin per watt. Similarly, RT1 will be conductive thermal resistance. Of cylinder, and it can be given as log of R2 over R1 over 2 pi k1 L Kelvin per watt. Similarly, RT2, so conductive thermal resistance of insulating material. So how can I write this RT2? Log of R3 over R2 over 2 pi K2L Kelvin per watt. Then RT3, thermal resistance, conductive thermal resistance. This is most important. Conductive thermal resistance of insulating material 2. And it can be given as log of R4 over R3 over 2 pi K3L Kelvin per watt. And final resistance is RT infinity O. And it is nothing but convective thermal resistance of cold fluid. In our case, we have taken cold fluid as air. So this can be written as 1 over H infinity O into AO Kelvin per watt. So this way we could represent all the thermal resistances in terms of radiuses and thermal conductivities. Now here we could represent the rate of heat transfer through individual layers of materials in the form of equation 1, 2 and 3. So here, now, we need to represent the heat transfer rate equation considering the inner fluid temperature and outer fluid temperature. So how can I write? So Q is equal to T infinity I minus T infinity O. And when I consider the inner and outer fluid temperatures, all the materials coming in between these two temperatures, their thermal resistances will come into picture. What does it mean? Here, I am considering this. I am considering the inner fluid temperature and outer fluid temperature. So what are the materials appearing in between these temperatures? Hot fluid, cylinder 1, insulating material 1, insulating material 2, and cold fluid. So their thermal resistances will come into picture. So how can I write? RT infinity I plus RT1 plus RT2 plus RT3 plus RT infinity O, or T infinity I minus T infinity O over summation of RT, where what is RT? Summation of RT is nothing but total thermal resistance of this composite wall or lagged pipe, and it can be given as RT infinity I plus RT1 plus RT2 plus RT3 plus RT4. And we have individual expressions for RT infinity I, RT1, RT2, RT3. This is RT infinity O. So this will be summation of RT. And we have the individual expressions for all these thermal resistances. So it will also represent the heat transfer rate through composite cylinder considering combined mode of heat transfer by conduction and convection as well. Now let us consider the second case. Case number 2. Considering thermal contact resistance. Now I am taking into account thermal contact resistance. So let us refer this diagram once again. Now as you can see here, in this diagram, the cylinder and insulating material is forming interface 1 and insulating material 1 and insulating material 2 is forming second interface. And for the sake of analysis, let us say these are in contact, these are not in perfect contact by virtue of their surface roughnesses. So an additional thermal resistance will be offered at these interfaces, which is called as thermal contact resistance. if I take into account the effect of thermal contact resistances, how this equivalent electrical circuit will change? So let me draw the electrical circuit only so that you can understand, better understand how to take into account thermal contact resistance. So heat conduction will take place. So first temperature difference will be T infinity 1. T infinity I and T1, thermal resistance will be RT infinity, the expression for which we have already derived in case 1. Second temperature difference will be T1, T2, and thermal resistance will be RT1 by cylinder. Now here, temperature drop will take place at the interface T2. And let's say it drops from T2 to T2A. And a thermal, additional thermal resistance will be offered, which is called as thermal contact resistance RTC at the interface 2. Then temperature drop will take place from RT2A to T3, and thermal resistance will be offered as RT2. Then T3 is again interface between insulating material 1 and 2. So temperature drop will take place from T3 to T3A, and this will be thermal contact resistance RTC3. Further temperature drop will take place from T3A to T4 in the insulating material 3, and it will be RT3. And finally, temperature difference between outer surface and cold fluid, and this is going to offer another thermal resistance by convection, RT infinity O. So now you can see here, if I am taking into account the effect of thermal contact resistances, two extra thermal resistances are coming into picture. So for this arrangement particularly, there are total thermal resistances which are going to offer to the path of the heat flow. RT infinity I, RT1, RTC2, RT2, RTC3, RT3, RT infinity. Okay. So the entire discussion will remain same. What will be total thermal resistance then? It will be summation of RT infinity I. So let me differentiate this. Thermal contact RT infinity I RT1 plus RTC2 plus RT2 plus RTC3 plus RT3 plus RT infinity O. So there are total 7 thermal resistors. One, two, three, four, five, six, 7 Kelvin per watt. And what will be the equation of heat transfer rate considering thermal contact resistances? T infinity I minus T infinity O over summation of RT considering thermal contact resistance. Isn't it? Now, what will be the effect of this these two thermal contact resistances? Because of introduction of this RTC2 and RTC3, the denominator will increase. So QTC will be less than Q. That is, if we consider the effect of thermal contact resistance, rate of heat transfer will decrease. Now, symbolically, I can also represent what exactly I am talking about. So, the first temperature drop will take place at the interface 2. So, temperature will drop from T2 to TA, T2A. Then in the material 2, then at interface 3, T3 to T3A. Okay. So here this temperature drop and this temperature drop because of thermal contact resistance. So if I refer this diagram, RT2A will be here and RTC3 will be here. Correct? So that is something where thermal contact resistance will come into picture and its effect we can take into account by writing the expression for total thermal resistance. This way we can analyze the heat conduction through composite wall or lagged pipe without thermal contact resistance and with thermal contact resistance. One more subtopic is remaining, that is overall heat transfer coefficient. Overall heat transfer coefficient comes into picture when there is a combined mode of heat transfer by conduction and by convection. And since in case of cylinder, we have inner area, inner surface area and outer surface area, both these areas are different. So, for cylinder, we can consider based upon inner area of cylinder. How can I write? What is the relationship between overall heat transfer coefficient? U into A is equal to summation of total thermal resistance. So we have the relationship, we have the expression for summation of RT in both the cases with thermal contact resistance and without thermal contact resistance. So you can get the UI. I am not going to derive it. You can easily do it. Then based upon outer area of cylinder, that is O. So I can write this expression UO into AO over 1 upon summation of RT. So this way we can get the expression for UI and for UO. So this is simply a mathematics. You have to do some rearrangement of the terms, so you will get the expressions for UINUO. So with this, I come to an end of this video lecture.